From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good evening and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Megan Torgerson. Portland Police Chief James Craig is one of about three dozen candidates for the same job in Cincinnati. Even though his name is in the mix, he says his focus right now is here in the city of Portland. 2 years ago, James Craig came from Los Angeles to take on the role of police chief here in Portland. During his 2 years in Portland, Craig has implemented community policing and received full support from city council regarding the use of tasers. Craig says one of his goals was to build a relationship with the community. Crime, the city of Portland says, is down 19% since the beginning of the year. There's no timeline when the field in Cincinnati will be narrowed, but Craig says this is a reflection of the city in general.
It's nice that I'm here experiencing and reaping the fruits of all of this, but the reality is it's the men and women and a supportive community that are making this happen.
Since the news broke about the Cincinnati job, Craig says he's been getting a tremendous amount of support from the community. The state fire marshal's office says a Brunswick man severely burned when his apartment caught fire in February, died over the weekend. 63-year-old Richard Rugg had been in the hospital since the February 16th fire swept through his apartment at 84 Union Street. Investigators say Rugg had been cooking on the stove when the fire swept his apartment. He suffered severe burns to more than half of his body and died Sunday at Maine Medical Center. A fire that destroyed a Brunswick apartment building early Sunday morning likely was caused by an electrical problem. The Maine State Fire Marshal's Office tells News 8 the fire at 45 Main Street began in a closed-in space under a center stairway on the Mason Street side of the building. Investigators found heavy charring in that area that leads them to believe the fire was electrical in nature. The Paris Fire Department says fire destroyed a house on Cottage Street overnight. Investigators say the home's smoke detectors alerted the owner to the flames. He was able to get out of the house safely. Several towns responded to the fire call. No one was hurt. The cause of the fire is still under investigation. State Fire Marshal's Office says too many people on a deck caused it to collapse early Sunday morning at the Rack Restaurant in Carabasset Valley. Investigators say 10 people were standing on the deck when it gave way and 4 people suffered broken bones after falling about 15 feet to the ground. Olympic gold medalist Seth Westcott is one of the owners of the restaurant. Several people in Lewiston are calling on the city to improve housing conditions in the downtown area. They're now urging city officials to add 2 housing code officers to the city's code enforcement department. Speaking on Knox Street this morning, the Neighborhood Housing League says Lewiston's current staffing levels for housing code are below the national level. The group says this puts residents in danger.
We urge residents to be proactive. Unfortunately, our city's code enforcement office is not staffed to be proactive. So it's really heavily dependent on tenants calling and notifying our city of the conditions they're living in. And then the second piece of our message is very simple and very clear. We believe that housing is a life safety issue and that poor housing affects our community and the health of our residents.
Basically, we're trying to find ways that we can respond to the issues in the residential areas downtown, maximize what we're currently doing with existing resources, and potentially supplement those resources using, in this instance, federal funding.